The inspiration come from a love of Hong Kong action cinema from the late 80s and 90s, like John Woo, Hardboiled, The Killer, and even modern Hong Kong action cinema like Infernal Affairs, but then also 70s cop movies like Bullet and The French Connection, and trying to marry that style and do something similar in London, in contemporary London, but showing a sort of aspirational sexy city.
Do you think you make London look as sexy as Hong Kong, Singapore?
I think so. Kind of a lot of the reviews have begun on about how the film is almost borderline sci-fi. They're saying the film's almost borderline sci-fi, and and I think that's what we always try to do, just like we try to visually push the visual medium. I think sometimes directors are too literal with London, and they always show the London Eye and Big Ben, and we don't see any of that in the film. You don't see any red buses, you don't see any police uniforms. We just tried to make it look sexy and more American to a degree.
Well, let's hope we can keep up with the Kardashians, as it were.
Yeah.
And your casting, how did you go for those guys?
Well, you know, James McAvoy, Mark Strong, Andrew Riseborough, Johnny Harris, Peter Mullen, they're all some of the, you know, the best actors in the country. And I think having an executive producer like Ridley Scott, who came on board to the film, he lent a certain cachet to the script and to me as a director, because he was executive producing. And that just meant that we could, you know, go out and make that movie. And it was great. I mean, that meant we could get that sort of cast, like somebody like Mark Strong, who's worked with Ridley Scott on films like Robin Hood and Body of Lies, knew that guy was championing me and supporting me, and it makes him feel much more comfortable as an actor, that he knew that at any time this young director could phone up Ridley Scott and ask his advice. And it was kind of almost like a mentor to myself.
And you'd work with some of those actors before, haven't you, in a previous film?
Yeah, there's Danny Mays, Jason Mazza, Jay Simpson, my wife Danielle Brent, who's in the movie as well.
Keeping it in the family.
And we were going to try and get Riz Ahmed, who played Shifty in my first film, but he was off shooting The Reluctant Fundamentalist, so he unfortunately couldn't make it onto the film.
So how did James sort of get his way into that family? Did he fit in very well, easily?
Yeah, like, you know, James and Mark, you've probably met, I don't know if you've got to interview James, he had to go off to go and do Macbeth, but they're very warm, lovely guys. And I think I don't sort of rule the set with a fear of tyranny or being a megalomaniac. I kind of like to make everyone feel very relaxed. And I'm often busting the Running Man on set, or like dropping music and like putting hip hop on and stuff.
We've heard that you have bundles of energy that you pour out onto your car.
Well, yeah, I'm always kind of like busting raps and sort of going up behind James's ear and just like going, singing Montel Jordan, this is how we do it. And like making him, but the whole point is just to make him laugh, basically. Do you know what I mean? The more you make an actor feel relaxed on set, the kind of more they'll give you back, because if you're, you know, they just kind of feel relaxed in your company, and hopefully they'll give you the performance.
But are you quite rare as a director in doing that?
I don't know. Like, I've heard that I was a runner. I started off as a runner, and I heard that I worked on a film called Millions with Danny Boyle, and he's lovely. Like, he talks to everyone. He's approachable. I don't know if you've ever met him yourself, but he's a very sort of tactile, warm, nice guy. But I don't think it is the general rule that all directors are tyrants. You know what I mean?
And right, tyrant. So this film is quite cops, villains-esque. What's the drama of that? What's the appeal of that?
Cops, villain-esque. I think I sort of figured it out. I've got an inherent love of good versus evil and goodies versus baddies. And I think all of my favourite films have always kind of had that as a sort of basis, do you know what I mean, as a rule. And even when you look at the films of someone like Ridley Scott, a lot of his greatest films, like Black Hawk Down, Gladiator, Alien, Blade Runner, it's kind of goodies versus baddies on a greater, more epic scale.
Right at the core, we've got that good versus evil.
Look at the sort of biggest films out there, like Lord of the Rings or Avatar or the Harry Potter movies. It's good versus evil, Star Wars, The Empire versus The Rebellion. It kind of all feeds in there, and that's what this movie is, a good movie about goodies versus baddies, a good cops and robbers movie on a weekend night. Go and watch it.
I will. Thank you so much, Aaron. Lovely to talk to you.